beautiful day in Athens. The Georgia Bulldogs make the dog walk into Sanford Stadium to play a game that may have a tremendous impact on their season and the future of the Georgia program. Last Saturday, the Dogs were sloppy in a season-opening loss to number 5 Boise State. Quarterback Aaron Murray hopes improved execution will lead to a big win today for Georgia and coach Mark Richt, whose job security has been the hot topic in Bulldog Nation.
It's our house! Defend this house! These are our hedges! This is our home! And it's just us right here!
Invading their home, South Carolina, the Gamecocks rallied from a 17-0 deficit to defeat East Carolina in their opener. Longtime Georgia tormentor Steve Spurrier arrives in Athens with a talented team, trying to turn up the temperature on Rick's already very hot seat and gain a leg up in the race for the SEC East title. Today, South Carolina takes on Georgia in what has been the traditional conference opener for these two teams since the Gamecocks joined the SEC in 1992. Everybody and welcome. I'm Sean McDonough along with Matt Millen. We'll be joined shortly by Heather Cox. Delighted to have you with us. They played a lot of exciting and close games in recent years, but perhaps none of the recent meetings between these two more important than this one for a variety of reasons. First and foremost, they're the top two favorites in the preseason SEC Bowl to win the SEC East. South Carolina 1 and Georgia 2. South Carolina comes here with a terrific juggernaut on offense.
They really do, and they come here with a terrific running back and sophomore Marcus Lattimore. Remember, just a year ago, he ran over, through, and around this Georgia defense to the tune of 182 yards. They used him early. They used him often. He can do it. He can do everything. He catches the ball well out of the backfield. Extremely good inside and outside. And he has some help. Steven Garcia came in a week ago, provided the spark they needed, made the big play down the field. And Alshon Jeffrey, a huge target who can really change the game.
Georgia Bulldogs taking the field before a crowd of more than 92,000 between the hedges. And the Gamecocks make their way onto the field with the record of 1-0. They won their season opener for the 13th straight year. And Steve Spurrier enjoys few things more than beating the Georgia Bulldogs all the way back to his playing days at Florida in the mid-60s. The Bulldogs on a downward spiral the last few years. Last season, 6-7. Their first losing mark since 1996 with the loss to Boise State. Now 14-13 since the start of 09. And that loss was their 8th in their last 9 games against ranked opponents. So for Georgia, a lot of issues. It'll be interesting to see how the crowd reacts here if the game does not start well for the Bulldogs. Mark Richt clearly on the hot seat. He acknowledges that. And they were sloppy. A lot of poor execution in that game against Boise State.
You're right on the money, Sean. And where they were really sloppy was in the offensive line. And let me tell you something. If you don't have an offensive line that's on, the rest of your offense is going to work, because Georgia has some players who can make some plays. Aaron Murray, just a redshirt sophomore, he can make big plays. He can play in the pocket, outside the pocket, throws well on the run, sees the whole field, very capable, had a big freshman year, and he's got some people who can help him as well. Just a freshman, Isaiah Crowell, in his second game, really wants to define what it is that he brought to the table. He's got lots of skills. And then Orson Charles. This kid, as a tight end, he presents mismatches inside and outside to get to the middle of the field. So if the offensive line does their job, they have others who can do theirs as well.
On a glorious September afternoon, 85 degrees as we approach kickoff. Georgia and South Carolina. The Bulldogs won the toss and deferred, so South Carolina will receive with Bruce Ellington back deep. Steven Garcia in the Gamecock offense will get the ball first. Blair Walsh to kick off. And the atmosphere befitting a very important early season conference game. Good boot by Walsh through the back of the end zone. Down on the field, here's Heather Cox.
Sean, thanks so much. As you mentioned, last year, Georgia struggled to contain Marcus Lattimore. Well, guys, that challenge could be even greater today, considering that linebacker Alec Ogletree is out for at least a month following surgery on a broken foot. Mark Richt said it is a huge blow to his defense and will use a walk-on and a freshman to split time in that position. But, Sean, the Georgia defense is compensating by promising to have at least two players tracking Lattimore on every play today.
Mark Richt said Alec Ogletree was, of all the players on the team, likely the player they could least afford to lose. They were already thin at inside linebacker with him. Garcia hands it off. Marcus Lattimore, after his coming out party last year as a freshman against Georgia, when he ran for 182 yards, gets three on that carry, tackled by Kwame Gethers in the middle of that front three, 3-4 defense for the Georgia Bulldogs. 37 carries last year in South Carolina's 17-6 win in Columbia, about 2.5 hours away. Garcia out of the gun now on 2nd and 7. Georgia brings a blitz, and Garcia dumped it off in the flat. Justice Cunningham, the tight end, the catch, and he's very near a first down. Lattimore and Jeffrey, the stars on offense. Lattimore, one of the best running backs in the country. Jeffrey might be the best wide receiver, and a veteran offensive line. 80 combined career starts and 3 senior starters. He throws deep down the field. He was totally out of sync there. Not a white shirt in the area. And South Carolina will punt.
Bruce Ellington went to the post. He must have misread it, and he took it to the out. But credit the Georgia defense for bringing pressure and setting up this fourth.
Joey Scribner-Howard in the punt. He won the punting job in training camp in an open competition. He's a transfer from Carson Newman, where he was a place kicker. Brandon Smith back for the punt. It's a short punt. Smith signaled that he was going to let it bounce and he was going to get away from it. Then he decided to field it, and he almost muffed it. He fell on it at the 18-yard line. A 50-yard punt with help from the bounce. Antonio Allen down there in coverage. And here comes Aaron Murray. The Georgia freshman record, 3,049 yards last season. Second highest passing total in a season ever by an SEC freshman. Only Jared Lorenzen of Kentucky back in 2000 threw for more yards in his first year than did Murray for Georgia last year. Richard Samuel opens as the tailback. We'll see a lot of the freshman Isaiah Correll. Big hole from that much criticized offensive line after their nightmare of a week ago. And a 13-yard rumble for Samuel, and they'll look to go no huddle.
Sean, you said it right. It's the offensive line. This time they came off the ball and got a body on a body and got a good push. A week ago, their first step was straight up and down. They lost leverage completely, and that's all they worked on all week long.
That's what these folks were hoping and expecting to see for the freshman from Columbus, Georgia. Samuel will split time with Crowell. Figgins is a converted tight end, now a fullback. And up front, Cordy Glenn, 38th consecutive start. Glenn Jones, the center, 37 straight starts. Correll, part of a big-time recruiting class dubbed locally as the Dream Team, finds another hole, bounces off some hooks. He's into the secondary. And down at the Gamecock 25-yard line. Shaq Wilson ran him down. The program that needs a lift is getting it immediately from Crowell.
You see his vision, Sean. His feet in the hole. He sees the whole field that has great feel and comes back right away. The crowd got excited, but not as excited as the coaching staff, which is in the booth right next to us. They were jumping up and down. They got something.
28-yard gain. They marked it at the 26. Crowell out for a breather. Richard Samuel, who was a running back, then a linebacker last year during a redshirt season. He returned to running back this year, and he's in. Behind Bruce Figgins, the fullback. He follows that blocker. Get tripped up and stumbled ahead for three. It'll be second and seven. DJ Swearinger, a hard-hitting safety, made the tackle for the Gamecocks.
You know, this defensive line for South Carolina has a lot of talent, but really where it shows up, and you can see Swearinger comes down and plays like a linebacker. But that defensive line really shows up in the pass rush. Right now, they're getting mauled.
Samuel to the 19-yard line. They did give up 37 points last week against East Carolina in that 56-37 win when the Gamecocks fell behind 17-0 and rallied. But the defense was put in some tough spots in the first half, in particular when the offense turned it over four times. Crowell's back in. Third down and three at the 19. More than midway through the first quarter, no score. Murray under duress again, forced to throw it away. Devin Taylor was putting on the pressure. They've been working with Murray to throw it more quickly to anticipate receivers coming open rather than wait until he sees them come open.
Yeah, that's what he's got to work on. And that time he had Wooten. It was man coverage, and he was waiting for him to clear back underneath, and he just waited too long, Sean. You're exactly right.
So Blair Walsh on to try the field goal. Another senior, one of the best kickers in the country. 37-yard attempt, and it is right down the middle. Good snap by Ty Fricks and hold by Drew Butler. And Georgia with Crowell off the bench, providing an instant spark, gets three. Crowell had runs of 15 and 28 on that drive to set it up. Back between the hedges in Athens, Georgia, the Bulldogs lead South Carolina 3-0. They went 50 yards in six plays. They set up a field goal by Blair Walsh of 37 yards. Isaiah Crowell rushed for 43 of those 50 yards in just two carries. Bruce Ellington and Kenny Miles for the kick. He booted his first one out of the back of the end zone. That's about 8 yards deep, and Ellington won't try it. First and 10, South Carolina. Steven Garcia in the shotgun. Fake the handoff. Flipped it up for Alshon Jeffrey, and he runs over would-be tacklers. And is near another first down.
Nicely done by Garcia when he sees the rotation. See how the corner drops back. And when he sees that, he knows he's going right outside to Jeffrey. Now, Jeffrey, a big man, not a fast starter. He gains speed as he goes, but he's good enough to get 8 yards right there.
Todd Grantham, the defensive coordinator, said had a tough time tackling Jeffrey last year. Garcia on the run, intercepted. Threw it up for grabs, and it was picked off. Bakari Rambo, who did not play last week and felt he really let the team down, suspended and didn't go against Boise State, an immediate impact in his return.
Not a great throw and not a great decision. There was no one there. He could have run for the first down. He wanted to get it to Jeffrey, but Rambo undercut it from underneath.
And Garcia has been way off so far in this game. Three interceptions last year for Rambo, a junior from Donelson, Georgia. Murray out of the gun. High throw over the head of Tavares King. It was a real struggle in their 17-6 loss at South Carolina for the Georgia offense last year. Just 253 yards and 11 first downs. Richard Samuel, the tailback, he gets the call. Off right guard and got slammed down after a gain of two. Antonio Allen made the tackle, coming off the best game of his career. He had 16 tackles A career high against East Carolina last week. Big third down here now for Aaron Murray and the Georgia Bulldogs. Third and nine. They are in field goal range for Walsh. When they pick up the rush, they had all kinds of problems protecting on third down last week. They're just 2 out of 13 against Boise State on third down and 0 for 2 today. Got a surprise with the run. Crowell tripped up from behind. That saved the first down. Nice tackle by Devontae Holloman. It looked like Crowell had a lot more running to do had he not been taken down from behind by the junior. So here comes the field goal unit again. Blair Walsh already kicked a 37-yarder. This will be 39, just inside the left hash mark. So 6 points for Walsh today, 312 now for his career, just 2 behind Herschel Walker for 4th place all-time Georgia scorer. Well, Russ doesn't seem all that excited about the start, and Stephen Garcia can't be either. 6-0 Georgia after 1. Brand new video board here at Sanford Stadium. $1.4 million to provide these fans with those pretty pictures. So the decision to punt by Steve Spurrier on that 4th and 1 paid off. Proved the field position after his defense got a stop. Best field position of the day for the Gamecocks. Lattimore couldn't stay on his feet as he crossed midfield. Went down to the 47 of Georgia. Good for a 6-yard pickup.
So, Sean, now when Garcia is in a funk like this, that effectively takes Alshon Jeffrey out. And that means Lattimore's got to carry the day, and the defense knows it.
Whoa, they weren't ready for the snap. Garcia wasn't. And South Carolina got it back. At the 46, they actually picked up a half yard. He was still signaling when T.J. Johnson snapped the ball.
Well, they are completely out of sync. But they are going to have to be able to run. If they're going to run, they're going to have to be able to run at 8-man fronts. And Lattimore is good enough to be able to do that with.
Here's the long back. 3 wide receivers on 3rd and 3. Lattimore, lots of running room. First down. Bakari Rambo made the tackle. Sean Williams also in on the play. Goes to the 38. 1st and 10, South Carolina.
So what Spurrier does instead is spread them out and goes with 3 wides. That removes a guy from the box, and it helps Lattimore. He gets to the edge with a big first.
9-yard gain for Marcus. Midway through the 2nd quarter, Lattimore fights his way inside the 35. Here's Reese Davis.
John, Virginia Tech is strolling into Dowdy-Ficklin Stadium in Greenville, North Carolina, expecting to waltz out with a victory. East Carolina at a 7-3 lead, but Josh Oglesby for the Hokies goes in tough. Early 2nd half, number 11 Virginia Tech on top by 3.
Steve Spurrier wasn't pleased with the way his team played against East Carolina last week. He used words like sloppy and sorry. They managed to rally back against the poorest Pirate defense to win. 2nd and 7. Garcia had a lot of time, ran out of it, throws on the run, caught! Alshon Jeffrey! And South Carolina is an extra point away from a lead. A 34-yard touchdown.
That was just schoolyard football, Sean. Exactly what we just spoke about a few minutes ago. They were one big play away. And Alshon Jeffrey is the guy who can make the big play. Garcia got outside the pocket and saw the one-on-one. He knew exactly where he was going.
16th career touchdown reception for the junior. St. Matthews, South Carolina. Jay Wooten adds the extra point. South Carolina, awful on offense until this possession, all of a sudden has the lead. Welcome back to ESPN's College Football presented by Cars.com and the SEC on ESPN. 34-yard touchdown pass. Garcia to Jeffrey. The extra point in South Carolina has the lead. Garcia had 31 yards passing before the touchdown. Got 34 on that one throw. Jay Wooten will kick off. And in Boykin, one of the best return men in the country, back deep. Four kickoff returns for touchdowns for Boykin, including one 2 years ago against South Carolina. Very nearly broke it. They got him down at the 36-yard line.
Let's take a look at this. They're going to go man-to-man outside here. Now, I want you to watch the safety and the quarterback because they are keys in the coverage. He comes up and gets physical first right there. Garcia eyeballing this side, pulls the safety out of the middle, and that effectively gives you one-on-one. Now, the sign of every great receiver is the ability to separate at the crucial point, and Alshon Jeffrey did just that.
Hand off to Malcolm Mitchell, freshman wide receiver, going across the formation, and the Gamecocks are ready for him. He's another headline member of that dream team, Mitchell. 24 games in a row now with at least three catches for Alshon Jeffrey, with three today, including the touchdown. Touchdown pass by Garcia, his second of the season. They completed only 10 passes last week against East Carolina. Murray tries to pull it down and run and has room and a first down. What a run by Aaron Murray to the 45-yard line of South Carolina, where he was tackled by Travion Robertson, 23-yard gain.
Devin Taylor leaves his helmet all the way at the other end right there. But Murray just takes off and runs. Great. This is exactly what they need. They need something to spur them on right now because they're in a funk as well.
Murray, first team preseason All-SEC. It's a conference that lost several headliner quarterbacks after last year. And off to Richard Samuel. He's down across the 42, gain of three. Here's Heather.
John, freshman running back Isaiah Crowell remains on the sideline. Ben Jones, his center, chewed him out after the last series for a missed assignment. Then the medical staff came over, removed his shoulder pads, added a layer of extra padding around his kidney and rib area. They said he's going to give it a go. Whether or not he's not playing because of the missed assignment or the ribs is yet to be seen, Sean.
He had some problems in pass protection last week. Not unusual for young player Samuel for a first down to the 31. Chopped down by DJ Swearinger. 10 more yards on the run for Georgia, and they're back in field goal range.
But Samuel is just enjoying some nice blocking up front. Good job by that offensive line that allows him to get to that second level. And he's a straight line guy. And Samuel is not a make you miss type of guy. So when he starts piling up the yards, you're doing well up front.
He's 243 pounds. Bouncing on bodies ahead for two. The 29-yard line, Rodney Polk made the tackle, sixth-year senior. Granted an extra year of eligibility because he missed almost two full seasons with knee injuries. Crowell back in with 4 minutes to go in the half. Georgia trying to reclaim the lead.
South Carolina not ready. Snap it. And to me, that's a wasted opportunity right there.
Murray looking to the sideline, now maybe changing the play. Burrell to the 26. Devin Taylor, the tackle for South Carolina.
Sean, that's one of the things you really, the trend in the last probably 5 or 6 years in the NCAA is all the coaching, all the play calling, all the adjustments, everything comes from the sideline. And so you'll watch offenses stop and turn to the sideline, and the defenses look at their sideline. And in that particular instance, we just saw a wasted opportunity to take advantage of an unprepared defensive front.
Quarterback Brandon Blinken on the offense again for Georgia. Murray, lots of time. Going deep, has a man. Touchdown. Rantavius Wilton puts Georgia back on top. Drive, 26-yard touchdown pass. The extra point up and good by Blair Walsh. Aaron Murray to Rantavius Wilton, the junior from Belgrade, Florida. Part of an inexperienced receiver group trying to fill the void with the departure of A.J. Green to the NFL. Georgia back on top, 13-0. Aaron Murray, a 26-yard touchdown pass to Rantavius Wilton.
Oh, CeCe Whitlock on the outside right here. Looks like they're going to play zone back underneath. Now, once he gets into that secondary, this safety is gone. This turns into a one-on-one with Whitlock. And his eyes right there. He bites back inside, and it's over.
Onside catch. They get a great bounce and recover it, but there is a flag down. At the Georgia line of scrimmage, they might have been offside. Bakari Rambo recovered the onside kick by Walsh, but there's a flag down.
And if it's not against Georgia, it would come back to where he recovered the ball. He can't return it that way.
Number 18 on the team. Penalty from the 30-yard line.
That was Rambo who recovered it.
Boy, it is really close, too. Just, I want you to watch the second guy in up top. That's Bakari Rambo. Watch, it's really... Yeah, he's stepping to kick. That is... Wow, that is really close. But they threw the flag. So it's coming back.
And it's interesting, because if you're a fan of Mark Richt, you'd say it's a great call. If you're not a fan, you'd quite clearly stand there. Oh, it's a desperate move by a desperate coach. Bruce Ellington runs the kickoff. Blair Walsh back to the 29-yard line. So 2:47 to go in the half. South Carolina trailing again. They were down 6-0, took a 7-6 lead. Now 13-7. They have just one timeout left. And the pass dropped by D.L. Moore. Big target at 6'4". Looked like he took his eye off the ball. He was thinking about turning to run. South Carolina burned two timeouts when Steve Spurrier thought about going for a 4th-and-1 on his own 29 earlier in this quarter with his team behind 6-0. After his two timeouts and a Georgia timeout in between, they decided to punt, and it paid off. Second and 10, a blitz. Garcia retreats and throws it away. And loudest noise of the day here for the defense for Georgia. Trying to defend a 3rd and 10. Garcia looked to the sideline. Some more hand signals from the coaches. Another blitz from Georgia. Garcia, what is he through? And the knee's down. It's a completion to Ace Sanders, but his knee hit the ground at the 32, so no run after the catch. And it's good for just a gain of a couple. Steve Spurrier doesn't like the call right in front of his sideline at the 32-yard line.
It's right in front of them. Boy, they're getting pressure, and they're bringing some blitzes. Well, the official's right there. He must have seen it hit the grass.
Sheldon Williams came on the, or Sean Williams came on the safety blitz. Thing to throw by Garcia. A little bit low, and Sanders, who was open, had to take a knee.
It's a fake! Executed to perfection by South Carolina. And it's a touchdown! Melvin Ingram.
And there's two numbers. That's the Melvin Ingram, the defensive lineman, which it appears it is. He's 275 pounds.
I think it's D'Angelo Smith. They have two numbers six.
Yeah, they do.
And it appears to be D'Angelo Smith. No, it is Ingram.
No, that is Ingram.
Yep. We talked about what a good athlete he was in high school, the quick six. Melvin Ingram, defensive lineman. Tremendous athlete. On the fake punt. We talked about how Steve Spurrier likes to gamble. The gamble paid off. Georgia tried to gamble. The onside kick would have worked. They were offside. South Carolina fake punt, 68-yard touchdown.
There's Ingram right there. See him, number six. The most impressive part of this, runs right through, right over a potential tackler, and then right there. That is, you can see he had running back skills in his high school days, and he still has them.
There's Brandon Boykin, who was back deep for the punt. And this is a defensive end and defensive tackle, Ingram, who's 276 pounds.
That didn't make the Georgia mascot too happy. But Sean, at 276, you're right. Now that's, you know, that's a hamburger away from 280, and that guy's running away from people.
Jay Wooten to kick off. High short kick. Potentially, this guy kicked it, and the fair catch made by Aaron White. Helter-skelter first half on both sides.
Yeah, we thought we were going to get some rock'em sock'em, and we got two offenses that were out of sync. And we got a couple of big plays, but we also have a good second half coming up.
Excellent tease by Matt Millen. Here is Heather Cox.
Sean, thanks so much. Mark, from a nullified onside kick to a fake punt for a touchdown. How did the last 2 minutes really shift momentum in this game?
Halftime scores. We're down by one. We're playing pretty darn.
Action, how would you assess their ability to protect Aaron Murray better in this half?
Oh, it's gotten better as the game is going on. Early on, not very good. As of late, it's been better.
Mark, thank you.
Heather Cox, always well prepared. One microphone doesn't work, grab another. So the difference in the game, the fake punt. And the long run by Melvin Ingram. Defensive lineman. Former running back. Back to his roots. 68 yards. A one-point lead for Carolina. Now the Bud Light halftime report. Here's Reese. At the half, South Carolina leading Georgia by one. Many members of the military in attendance here today being saluted by this sellout crowd at Sanford Stadium. And with tomorrow, the 10-year anniversary of 9/11. And man, I know those images mean a lot to all of us, but as someone who has a son serving in active duty overseas right now, I'm sure particularly emotional for you.
Yeah, it gets you.
Well, God bless your son. We hope he comes back soon and safely. And God bless all the men and women of our armed services. This game, very interesting, kind of hard to describe what happened in the first half because it was a bunch of everything in terms of offense, not a whole lot of sustained anything.
Well, a couple guys who didn't disappoint, though, was Isaiah Crowell. He came out running the ball very well. and Melvin Ingram. Melvin Ingram had a heck of a first half.
Jay Wooten kicks off for South Carolina to begin the half. And Boykin, a couple of nifty spins. Began an additional 8 yards or so. Out near the 38-yard line. They couldn't believe it here at Sanford Stadium. Melvin Ingram runs 68 yards with a fake punt. First snap, bobbled by Murray. He lost two. It was almost as if, and I wouldn't put this past Steve Spurrier, he was saying, okay, you want to try an onside kick on us? Take this fake punt.
Well, it was timely, and it was perfectly executed. And Ingram showed the kind of athlete that he really is. I mean, he's a legitimate player. Except we said he's the best player in this defense.
They say he can throw a football 70 yards, and he is a very good punter. Left-footed, even though he throws right-footed. Tavares King, the ball carry, got to the 39. Here's Heather Cox.
Sean, no surprise, Steve Spurrier very frustrated by the lack of offensive output in the first half, but he said, we will stick with Steven Garcia. We will live or die with Steven Garcia. He'd like to see more balance in the second half. I also asked him about that fake punt. He said, our special teams coach told us if they give us a certain look, it's there. Sure enough, it was there. Guys, quick injury report. Isaiah Crowell bothered by bruised ribs for Georgia, and South Carolina's Sean Carson out with a knee sprain.
So credit to John Butler, the special teams coach, with a good call. Third and nine. Murray throws, caught. First down. 50-yard line. The true freshman Malcolm Mitchell with his first catch of the day. Good for 11 yards.
Well protected. And his mechanics are really good right here. Watch his feet. Step. Delivers a perfect ball right in front of Stephon Gilmore, the all-SEC corner.
It was 4 out of 9 for Murray. First and 10, Georgia, down by a point. After the good punt return at the 43 of South Carolina. Screen, Isaiah Crowell. Down to the 20-yard line. Good call, well executed this time by Georgia for a 23-yard gain.
And Crowell must have sucked up the pain on the ribs here, because he's in there and he's giving it everything. Nicely done on the front end on Ingram, because he has to draw him in and then slip him, which he does very well.
Reginald Bowens ran the play down from behind. First and 10, Georgia, in field goal range to reclaim the lead, but they'd like 7. That's even 8 at this juncture. Isaiah Crowell again. 3 to the 17-yard line. We're under 7 minutes to go, third quarter.
You know, you watched him in that opener, and you saw that he has some skills, but you're really waiting for him to really define what he is. And I think today he's done that. Very patient runner. For a young player, that's impressive.
Here comes the rush, and Murray got it off, and it's incomplete. Rantavius Wooten couldn't catch it. Last week, Tavares King had difficulties in the game against Boise State. The coaches wonder if some of these wide receivers are putting too much pressure on themselves, trying to take the place of A.J. Green. Or sometimes you just drop the ball.
Yeah, just relax. I mean, it looked like he waited on that one. He didn't attack the ball. He let it come to him.
Back to the screen again. Crowell inside the 5. Touchdown!
You gotta like the call by Mike Bobo, the offensive coordinator. It worked earlier, and he came right back to it. And the whole key is to allow them to come in, which they do. They actually caught him in a stunt. And Clowney can't catch Crowell.
Extra point up and good by Blair Walsh. Georgia back on top by 6. They needed only 3 plays. They go 43 yards after the excellent punt return by Brandon Smith. Crowell the touchdown. It's a 6-point lead for Georgia, his first career TD. sun is starting to set on a beautiful cloudless day here in Athens, Georgia. The curtain is just rising on the career of Isaiah Crowell. Screen pass taken in by the true freshman for his first career touchdown. Georgia back on top in what has become a back and forth affair. Larry Walsh into the end zone. Bruce Elligan's going to try it. And we got just across the 20. Let's go back to the Georgia score.
There has to be a couple of elements. First, you have to be able to get them drawn up inside. Now, Mike Bobo, the offensive coordinator, calls it to the left side, and it's a perfect call because he catches them in a stunt. So here they come. That's the first thing. The second thing is right over here, Dallas Lee, number 64. That's Shaq Wilson, 54. He has the coverage on Crowell. And Lee takes care of the coverage, and Crowell takes care of the score.
Well, he's a first-time starter. First and 10, South Carolina. 6 minutes to go. Third quarter, and Garcia blitzed them level from behind by Sanders Cummings.
God grant them, the defensive coordinator dialed up some blitzes at the end of the first half, and he is not slowing down. You're going to watch him come. Usually they come out of the slot. This time it's out of the corner.
Whoa.
And so it's incumbent upon the quarterback to have an awareness of those corners.
Garcia did very well to hang on to that ball. He never saw or felt Cummings coming. It's the second game of the year, the first conference game, but these fans know how important it is. Garcia just trying to flip it ahead to Lattimore. It's an incomplete forward pass, a very ugly looking incomplete forward pass. And this Gamecock offense out of sync again.
Yeah, this is the one thing with Garcia. There will be times when he's just a head scratcher. And not only you sitting at home are scratching your head, but Marcus Lattimore scratching his head as well. I mean, he was about 3 feet from him.
Up and down career, on and off the field for Garcia. Five times suspended by Steve Spurrier. Only to be brought back. Battling incredible crowd noise here. Play clock at two. Here comes the rush again. He got it off. Caught. Ace Sanders out of bounds, short of the first down.
Jarvis Jones right in his face.
Sanders went out at the 18-yard line, well short of the first down. There's the pressure by Jones. They're starting to get a lot of licks on Garcia. Joey Scribner-Howard with Malcolm Mitchell, the true freshman, back there now. With Smith and Boykin being banged up a little bit. And the punt down just across midfield by Quinn Smith. And he'd already committed to Georgia. The coaches weren't all that happy when he told him he wanted to go back and play. There's a fumble recovered by Gilmore. Heading the other way for the Gamecocks. Looking for blockers. Stephon Gilmore down at the five. Run down by Michael Bennett.
Never really had his hand on that exchange, Sean. Nobody had control, and no control was gained until Stephon Gilmore picks it up. And then what a fantastic job of weaving his way through it, trying to find his blockers. You called it right. He picked them up and then came back to the other side.
I thought he was slowing down there, but I don't know if he was waiting for another blocker out of gas or if he thought he was just going to waltz in and score. And they got him at the five, which could be a big play. Crowell the fumble. 57-yard return.
I would have to think this has got to be all Lattimore down here.
First turnover for Georgia today. Garcia faked to the Lattimore and got wrapped up by Christian Robinson, the son of a Gamecock. What a terrific young man he is. three times in high school. He spent his spring break overseas in Africa, working to help youngsters, most of them stricken with AIDS. But he'll never forget those faces. And it helps remind him, even if football isn't going as well as Georgia hopes, how blessed he is. Second and goal, they're offside. Garcia takes off on a free play, touchdown. It should stand. They didn't stop the play, which typically means it's against the defense, and it appeared to be a Georgia offside.
Number 29 on the defense,
Tony
Devine, touchdown.
Yes, so Sean, not only does he jump offside to give a free play, but now there's no edge set on the defense. Watch, he's going to jump up, and he's offsides. Okay, so now look, now he comes up, and now there's no edge whatsoever to defend. And Marcus Lattimore is able to get the block. He gets him in for six.
Critical extra point. And a good job by the holders. Seth Strickland to get down the snap from Walker and Abinett. And the extra point good by Jay Wooten. Five lead changes in this game. For the third time today, South Carolina leads by one. South Carolina has taken the lead. In a day of big plays for the Gamecocks, a 34-yard touchdown pass for their first score. Garcia to Alshon Jeffrey. The long run on the fake punt by Melvin Ingram, 68 yards, and then officially a 56-yard fumble return by Stephon Gilmore to set up the touchdown run by Steven Garcia. Isaiah Crowell put it on the ground, and the Gamecocks capitalized. 2.5 to go, third quarter, they're up again.
So let's see how Isaiah Crowell responds to a little adversity. He's passed every test so far.
Jay Wooten will kick it away for South Carolina. Number 12 in the country trying to get to 2.5. Good kick toward the sideline to Brandon Boykin. In trouble inside the 20 and swung down. That was terrific coverage all the way by Marty Marquette.
Kayvon Clowney is a player who has great skills, and he just doesn't, he's just being introduced to big time college football. In high school, he just dominated everybody physically, and he's working on it. He's got, you can see he's going to be really good. He uses his hands well, has a great motor.
Really just needs to get in the weight room, get bigger and stronger, and then look out.
And there's technique.
4.5 40.
Yep.
Long arms. First and 20. Murray steps into a throw. Intercepted. Another big play by South Carolina. Antonio Allen brings it in.
It was man coverage. Allen did a great job of hanging on the outside because there was pressure with a blitz coming inside. Murray tried to sneak it in, but Allen cut it off underneath.
Well, last week, South Carolina scored on offense, defense, and special teams, and they've done it again today. 25-yard return by Antonio Allen, the senior from Ocala, Florida, who ran a fumble in 25 yards for a touchdown last week against East Carolina. He's a contender for team-leading score, a linebacker.
Well, he played terrific last week, and he's following up again today. They come with a blitz inside. They know now that you're matched up man-to-man. Now, he's going to hold outside position, which is great because all you're doing is you're taking one thing away and you force him to go inside where you can make the play. As a defender, that was played perfectly. I was trying to get to Orson Charles, who we have not really called his name much, but he held the outside, which gives you only one way to go. And then that's the way you play it. Boy, Allen played it really well.
Mentioned he had the fumble return for a touchdown last week in the regular season finale against Clemson. Last year, he had an interception return for a touchdown. So that's three straight regular season games in which he has scored. Still a one-possession game with Georgia down by eight. Under 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Brandon Boykin. Four career kickoff returns for touchdowns. That's the SEC record. He doesn't even get the 15-yard line. On their own 12-yard line, Aaron Murray out of the shotgun. Short completion to Tavarius King. 7-yard gain. Here's Heather.
Sean, you talked about Aaron Murray's toughness. You saw him come up limping two possessions ago. No less than five members of the athletic training staff came over to him. He shunned them all off and said, I am absolutely fine. After that last interception, he came over, started testing that leg a little bit more, but then immediately looked ahead, went over to his offensive line group, told him to stay focused.
7-3. Malcolm Mitchell, the freshman, with the catch across the 30 and a first down. 12-yard gain. C.C. Whitlock, Jimmy LeGree combined on the stop for the Gamecocks. As we approach 1 minute left in the third quarter, another tight one in a rivalry filled with close and exciting games in recent years. Three wide receivers for Murray, again out of the shotgun. Four-man rush, but they put pressure on. Floater is caught by Marlon Brown. Lunged ahead, gain of about 8.5 by Brown, who's questionable coming into this game with an ankle injury. You see he's hobbling a bit as he gets up.
Both these teams are not afraid to bring pressure. And they've been doing it to both quarterbacks. Looks like Murray's finding a little bit of a rhythm right here.
Agusti with the stop.
3-for-3 on the drive. 2nd and 2. Final seconds of the third quarter. SEC opener. In the teams with first and second in the SEC preseason poll in the East. South Carolina 1, Georgia 2. Samuel the catch and the first down.
Just nice, simple reads. Taking either backs out of the backfield, quick screens, that just getting rid of the ball quick, making quick decisions. He's finding his rhythm right now.
8-yard gain. It'll be the last play of the third quarter. A good one between the hedges in this border rivalry. Steve Spurrier says within the SEC, Georgia, South Carolina's biggest rival. Of course, overall, Clemson in state, the big rival for the Gamecocks. 28-20, end of three. We welcome you back to Athens, Georgia, fourth quarter. College football presented by Cars.com. South Carolina leading Georgia 28-20. Georgia ball first and 10, their own 47. This drive started at the Georgia 12. Aaron Murray's 4-for-4 on the drive for 35 yards.
Brandon Boykin in the backfield here.
Defensive player seeing some snaps on offense. Malcolm Mitchell looking for blocks from his fellow wideouts. Got 8.5 on first down. Akeem Agusti, a backup defensive back, made the tackle.
Georgia doesn't need a big play. They need consistency. They've been finding it at the end of the third and in this drive right here. Brandon Boykin is a guy they want to get the ball in his hands. He's in the game. And Mitchell as well is an explosive player.
Blitz. Murray saw it. Hits the slant. Marlon Brown battling. Down near the 30. Shaq Wilson made the tackle. Murray continues perfect on the drive.
Yeah, and because he has good vision and he's able to see the pressure coming and makes the quick decision, knowing if it's coming from that side, you're going to have coverage on the top of it. There's a void underneath. Allow your receiver to get in there, and he makes the big play.
Lincoln still on the field for the offense. We haven't seen Isaiah Crowell at running back since his fumble. Good catch on a high throw. Malcolm Mitchell down near the 22-yard line. Stephon Gilmore made the tackle.
Here comes Crowell into the game. Murray's really bounced back here after this, after the turnover. He's finding his rhythm and he's seeing things fast, making good quick decisions.
7 for 7 on the drive. Second a short two. Over a long one. Depending on how you look at it. Crowell drives for the first down.
Crowell looks at it as a first down.
Two hands around the ball there too as he turned to the 19. Approaching the first 100-yard game of his career, and this is second game. Last year was a highly touted South Carolina freshman, Marcus Lattimore, who announced his arrival in this rivalry game. He had 182 yards for South Carolina against Georgia. Murray on first and 10, another quick punt. Michael Bennett in the secondary, in the end zone. Touchdown, Georgia.
That looks like they're going to go for two.
I would think you would here in the fourth quarter.
Beautifully crafted and executed drive by Aaron Murray.
Some confusion on the Georgia sideline. They still haven't run the play clock yet, so they have time. What a drive by Murray. 8 for 8 for 85 yards, 19-yard touchdown pass to Michael Bennett. First career touchdown for the redshirt freshman, who didn't have a catch in his career prior to today. He's out of Alpharetta, Georgia. Now a critical two-point conversion. Four wide receivers, three to the right of Murray. Richard Samuel, the running back. South Carolina rush four. Murray with time. Has his man for the two-point conversion. Tavares King ties the game at 28. Georgia Bulldogs talked about how desperate they are to win games, to try to help the job security of Mark Richt. In the middle of this sellout crowd, Aaron Murray's family right in the middle of the screen. His brother Josh, who was a walk-on football player here last year at age 26. He's graduated, former minor league baseball player. Good boot by Blair Walsh. Another one into the back of the end zone. Can South Carolina sustain offense now to reclaim the lead? They've had just 262 yards of offense. They've scored a touchdown on defense, a touchdown on special teams. They get started at Lattimore. A tough 9-yard run. Tied at 28 in this SEC opener. The two teams with conference title hopes and perhaps more. Lattimore into the secondary. Gets a block from Alshon Jeffrey and finally gets ridden out of bounds in Georgia territory at the 47. 24-yard run by Lattimore.
I watched the vision. He sees the whole field and he can get out. You know, I once asked Barry Sanders about runner's vision. And I said, Barry, how do you see all those things? And he said, you know, I see the same thing you see. I can just get there. And that's exactly what Marcus Lattimore can do. He sees the whole field, and he can get there.
Sixth career 100-yard game now. This is just his 15th career game. 115 yards rushing. Lattimore puts his head down. And a heavy collision after a gain of one. Sean Williams, the safety, junior from Damascus, Georgia. quickly about Lattimore. It doesn't matter. Well, he carries 30, 35, even 40 times. He never seems to get worn down. Garcia throws. Incomplete. Caught by Ace Sanders. But he was out of bounds. It'll be third down and 9.
And Todd Grantham coming again with pressure. Well, that's a good call. Put out of bounds. The official right there can see the whole thing.
It'll be about a 48-yard field goal. Jay Wooten still hasn't tried one for South Carolina. A couple of years ago at North Carolina, his long was 43. Garcia in the traffic, intended for Jeffrey, and broken up. Makari Rambo's made a big difference in that secondary today. Suspended and did not play last Saturday night in the Georgia Dome in their loss against Boise State.
Well, you can see the pressure again. They get a nice chip on him. Makari Rambo, he was dialed in on Alshon Jeffrey. Any inside move he was going to take away, he did.
There's Jay Wooten. First career field goal attempt as a South Carolina Gamecock. With all kinds of pressure on it. 49-yarder. Hit it well. Right down the middle and good. With 8.5 to go. Wooten, who had to win the place-kicking job in a spirited battle in the preseason. His first attempt as a Gamecock, memorable and good for a 3-point lead at Georgia. What a terrific game here in Athens, Georgia, and still 8.5 minutes to go between the hedges. One tie at 28, 5 lead changes in this one. Jay Wooten, the most popular man in Columbia at the moment, with his 49-yard field goal, kicks off. Brandon Boykin from the 5. Brandon Boykin all the way to the 37-yard line. Very nearly had his 5th kickoff return for a touchdown in his career. Marty Marquette prevented it.
It's easy to see why this Georgia coaching staff is excited about Brandon Boykin. Just great running. Has good defensive skills. And he puts him right now, he's put him in a position to be able to at least tie this thing up.
58-yard return. Yeah, they're already in field goal range according to Mark Richt. He thinks Walsh has a high percentage chance of making it from 57 yards. So that would be from the 40-yard line as the line of scrimmage. Perlow gets them closer. Down to the 28-yard line, pulled down by Rodney Paul. Second and short for Aaron Murray and George as the clock goes under 8 minutes. Second and a long one. Murray out of the gun. Burrell up to 103 yards rushing. First career 100-yard game. Murray just did get it off, and it's dropped by Malcolm Mitchell, the true freshman, who would have had a first down.
And Murray took a shot off a blitz on the edge. Just off the backside, there's the hit. And this is the drop. It was tipped. Mm-hmm. Mitchell still had it in his hands. And the sign, the difference between a good and a great play is the catch.
Although Devin Taylor tipped it, a big play for the Gamecock defense. On one of those pesky third downs that have been problematic for Georgia in their first two games against these ranked teams. And what a catch! Michael Bennett emerging as a star here in the second half. Tremendous catch to move the chains.
Working off the jam, Murray puts it the only place it can go, down low. Watch him. This is the fingertips, and it bounced off a defender as it came off his hand. He still made the catch. That's big time.
Redshirt freshman did not have a catch prior to today. He has already scored a touchdown, and that catch almost as big. And the 24. Open in the flat, the fullback, Bruce Biggins. He's near another first down at the 15-yard line. Looks like they'll mark him a foot or so short of it. Chopped down by Quinn Smith, the backup linebacker. Murray's over 200 yards passing.
You know, if you look at his body of work, Sean, ever since he threw the pick, it's like he's dialed in and he's focused.
Isaiah Crowell delivers the stiff arm. Touchdown! Georgia has the lead back.
He is what he was supposed to be.
Coming off a 6-7 season a year ago, you wonder why Georgia was a ranked team in the preseason, picked second in the SEC East, largely because of this Dream Team recruiting class headlined by Crowell, who's living up to the headlines today. The important extra point makes it a 4-point margin. 15-yard touchdown, back and forth we go in Athens. Georgia is retaking the lead. And Boykin's 58-yard kickoff return set it up. They went 37 yards in five plays. One of the biggest, that terrific catch on third down by Michael Bennett. We got a warm hug that lasted a long time for this coach, Mark Richt. Very important catch in this game, and perhaps for Mark Richt's future. Bruce Ellington brings the Carolina kickoff return out to the 21. Each team penalized five times. Garcia under center again. They faked it to Lattimore. Garcia looking deep. Throws! Caught! Ace Sanders into Georgia territory. Out of bounds inside the 40 with a first down.
He will surprise you with throws like this and how accurate this throw is on the run. He puts it right where Sanders can get the only place he can get it. That's a heck of a throw.
Looks kind of like his whole career at South Carolina, on and off the field. Steven Garcia can be so bad and so good.
Yes, he can. We got the good Garcia right now.
30-yard gain. Back to Lattimore, throw a big hole into the secondary. Bidding to give them the lead. Inside the two.
And if there's one tiny chink in Lattimore's armor, you just saw it. You really would love to see the next gear. But, oh, is he a heck of a player. This guy's a stud. Couldn't quite outrun that angle.
Sanders Cummings had the angle, took advantage of it. But it's a 36-yard run. .159 today. Jenkins, their big number six on the defensive line, junior college transfer in his first year at Georgia. Highly touted coming in out of Mississippi Gulf Community College.
A big, powerful man. If you think Melvin Ingram's six looks small, Jenkins looks tiny.
He's 351 pounds out of Meriden, Connecticut.
I still think right here you have to go to Lattimore, but I wouldn't be surprised if they just dumped it to him.
They're setting up a bunch to Garcia's left. Now they shift over to the right. Toss to Lattimore. Following those blockers. Touchdown, South Carolina. And the lead again for the Gamecocks with 3.5 to go.
This is, I want you to watch how Marcus Lattimore finishes the run. Once he gets his shoulders squared to the line of scrimmage, he is downhill in a hurry. Watch this. Stick that foot in right there. Now watch him just finish. Run behind his pads, just carry the pile. Watch him blow. That is really well done.
First touchdown of the day for Lattimore. Extra point is good. And that's baked by Jay Wooten. It makes it a three-point game. Now Georgia could only tie South Carolina with a field goal. 3:28 left and three timeouts for Mark Richt and Georgia.
And let's not underestimate the role that Brandon Boykin has played here in this game. He has consistently given them big returns, and that's what they're counting on right now.
Last one was 58 yards to set up a touchdown. You saw Blair Walsh, their kicker, strong leg, 57-yard range, according to Coach Rick. His career long 53. Wooten's kickoff down to Boykin at the goal line. Rocked out of bounds, far sideline by Sherrod Golightly, who did not go lightly on Boykin.
No, he didn't.
Since Murray threw the touchdown, the interception rather, that was returned by Antonio Allen for a touchdown, he is 10 for his last 11 passing. 3:21 to go, all three timeouts. South Carolina doesn't have any. Three wide receivers, and Murray couldn't even complete his drop. Then he fumbles the football. Jadeveon Clowney knocked it loose, and Melvin Ingram has scored again. Touchdown, South Carolina. And a two-score lead for the Gamecocks with 3:12 to go.
You know, as a pass rusher, Sean, you're never going to be an effective outside rusher until you take the inside. Once you establish you can take the inside, that outside opens up. Well, Jadeveon Clowney, he just took the inside and forced the sack and made a huge play.
Second touchdown by the defense. They set up another with that long fumble return by Stephon Gilmore. The special teams have scored a touchdown. The extra point good by Wooten. And it's the largest lead of the day now for either team.
Watch Clowney up top. He's going to take that hard inside move. They're bringing a blitz. And Melvin Ingram was on the outside. He was the second part of that rush. Well, Clowney knocks the ball out, and Ingram just cleans it up. You know, it's always amazing to me that great players make big plays in clutch situations. And Clowney, who's had a kind of a quiet day, but a great motor, and Ingram, who's had two touchdowns today, they found a way to make the play.
Two touchdowns in 28 seconds for South Carolina. 5-yard return by Ingram after the highly touted freshman Jadeveon Clowney made the biggest play of his two-game career at South Carolina. Short. On the break it again. He's dragged out of bounds on the far sideline. Corey Addison made the tackle for South Carolina. Good field position. Murray steps up, runs. Stayed in bounds, stopped the clock for a moment to move the chains. Took a hit from Antonio Allen. They got into South Carolina territory. They'll mark him down at the 45. First down, 17-yard run for Murray.
Antonio Allen's turned in a second consecutive big game. Made big plays. He'd had a lot of tackles here today. Good in the coverage side. Two consecutive big games.
And a touchdown and an interception return. Murray giving time this time. Cuts it short. Crowell dropped it as he crossed the middle. 2:39 to go. And many of the fans are starting to head dejectedly for the exits here. To Malcolm Mitchell, another first down. Inside the 35, marked at the 33, tackled by Stephon Gilmore. 12-yard gain, clock runs under 2.5 as they wind it after the chains were set. Murray going deep, one-on-one coverage, it is caught, touchdown! Well, maybe those folks who are in a big hurry to get out of here might turn back around and take their seats. It's a one-score game, and Georgia has all three timeouts left. Question was Tavarius King inbounds? And the answer is yes, by an inch or two, with the official right on top of it. Might have gone away with a little shove into the back of C.C. Whitlock.
Whitlock had decent coverage. But, boy, you really like the decision of Murray. He knew he had a one-on-one out there, and he knew what King could do, so he put it up high.
Fourth touchdown pass for Murray. That's a single game best for him. They took just 57 seconds to go 62 yards in four plays. 33-yard touchdown pass to Tavarius King. And now a huge extra point by Blair Walsh. It is already a one-score game, but now it makes it a field goal game that could tie it. Some of those people who are leaving are coming back in. Wild fourth quarter. Georgia scored 22 points in this quarter, South Carolina 17, and a wild game. Offense, defense, special teams. They have their backup kicker, Brandon Bogate, on the field. And the way he is lining it up, it looks like they are going to play for the onside kick. Ace Sanders, the only man back deep, and he's at the 25-yard line. 10 men up for the Gamecocks. High in the air it goes. And controlled by Melvin Ingram.
That kid is a stud. That guy is a great athlete, Sean.
Tremendous athlete. What a game he's had. He's been the special team star.
I would think that he might be the only defensive lineman in the country who's on the hands team for onside kick.
And you saw why. Pretty good vertical there, too. So now a must stop for the Georgia defense. First and 10, South Carolina at the 40. We'll expect a heavy dose of Marcus Lattimore here. Up the middle, good run on first down. He got six to the 34-yard line. Georgia uses its first timeout with 2:07 to go. Second and three, one more first down, and that's just about it for this one. Lattimore, 168 yards after his 182 against the Dogs last year. They hit him immediately with that great body lean forward that Steve Spurrier loves. He managed to get about a half yard. Cornelius Washington made the tackle. Georgia's not going to use the timeout here. Well, they're going to let South Carolina run off the entire play clock and take it down to about a minute 20 left before they have to snap it again. Much better able to stop the clock when you're on offense. We're seeing that Wooten has field goal range here if they get stopped, but you wonder if they try it. Lattimore outside. First down, South Carolina.
Boy, he's an impressive player, isn't he? Marcus Lattimore beats you inside. He beats you catching the ball. He beats you in cutbacks, and he beats you to the outside.
Georgia has used its second timeout, but they have only one left. Well, after last week's game, Mark Richt talked about the terrific effort and the great attitude of his team. And they certainly fought valiantly again today, but it's not good enough. And when the fans are frustrated, that's just going to sound like excuse-making. Well, South Carolina on the verge of back-to-back wins over their border rival Georgia for the first time since 2000 and 2001. For just the sixth time in the history of the series, which dates back to 1894. It is clearly a program on the rise in Columbia, South Carolina, while the Georgia slide continues. They will now be, barring a miracle, 14-14 in their last 28 games of losses. In 9 of their last 10 against ranked opponents. 7-10 in their last 17 SEC games. Numbers a lot of these Georgia fans are familiar with. And the speculation about Mark Richt's future was intense all week long. It'll be even more so in the week to come. Tremendous record in his first 7 or 8 years as the head coach. Players love him, but he acknowledges, rightly so, it's about wins and losses. And right now, they're not winning enough.
It's a long season, though, Sean. And this team played pretty darn well, just couldn't overcome all the mistakes.
First 0-2 since 1996. That was their most recent losing season prior to last year's 6-7. Steve Spurrier celebrates another win. For Matt Millen, Heather Cox, and our crew, Sean McDonough, saying so long from Athens. Final score, South Carolina 45, Georgia 42.